Get your special horoscope for the year ahead, 2020, at NadiaShaw.com. Hello, fabulous Capricorn. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of January 2020. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. It is this month that holds so much change and promise and potential. Now, a part of the reason is because of the rare meeting in the sky of Saturn and Pluto. These two planets are getting together in your sign is a truly rare phenomenon indeed. You won't see anything like this again for the rest of your life, in our lifetime certainly. But it isn't just about these two planets, but the other planets around it that are going to be adding energy, adding fuel, adding awareness, mainly the Sun and Mercury. So there's this added addition of heat to an already important configuration. The fact that this is happening in your sign does represent a moment of power, of focus, and of profound and meaningful transformation. This is about you getting in touch with some truth about yourself, and it changes a lot. It could change just about everything. Considering the fact that simultaneously we are having a lunar eclipse in your opposite sign, well, it does suggest your one-on-one interaction with another person is part of it. And part of what changes, in addition to you changing, it's as if your partnerships must change at this time if they are going to continue. For some, certain partnerships could come to an end very quickly, but it really is for the best. It's like by ending, it allows you to be more you than you could before. The restrictions fall away, and now you are restored to power as a result of the people who leave. But for others, this is going to be partnerships transforming from the inside out, changing the dynamic in some significant way so that it works going forward from here. This is a lunar eclipse, so there is a lot of emotion at this time, but there's also a strong sense of consequence. It is a time of all or nothing, especially where it comes to another person. And that in turn is going to allow you to decide the best course forward from here. So because we're talking about partnership, I do think a lot of Capricorns out there are going to find this to be an incredibly important month in the context of love, a defining time, if you will. If it is that you are open to meeting someone new, a lunar eclipse in your opposite sign, look, a full moon in your opposite sign would bring someone, but this is a lunar eclipse. And then you add to it, it is a jacked up lunar eclipse, meaning it's got all that energy coming from you. The energy of Saturn, the energy of Pluto. And all of this adds to that much more a moment where chances are you are going to connect with someone. And this is about you understanding yourself, where you are in love and why, how you feel about it, like truly putting aside any other, you know, aspirations or desires or questions. How do you truly feel about being open to new people, and why is that? This is your great opportunity to come to some truth about yourself as a result of your interaction with another. For those of you who are just starting to date somebody, again, moment of truth, who is this person really? Who are they to you? Why are they in your life? How do you really feel about them? All of this is going to come to the surface very strongly for some. Now, what it is you see, it is going to be all or nothing. So either you see something that propels you towards this person that much more, or you see something in this person and realize something about yourself and you go the other way. This is a consequential time where it comes to love or potential love, a time where it either is going to be clear that this is the one for you, or it is going to be clear that this really might not be the one for you. And for those of you in an established bond, again, it's an important time within your bond. It does look like whether it is that changes are taking place and it is speaking to your relationship, or whether it is that your partner is having experiences in their own life and it is speaking to how it is you feel about it, about yourself, all of this comes to the surface now. If there have been any buried issues, issues that the two of you haven't wanted to look at, you're getting along to get along, well, that's not really going to work under this sky. So remember, we're building towards this as we start the month, but the eclipse is exact on the 10th of January. The conjunction in your sign is exact on the 12th. So from a celestial perspective, we have got this chunk of time that is going to feel important and imperative where it comes to making a decision within your established bond as to its future and as to its meaningfulness to you. The great thing is, though, with energy like this, if this is the person for you, times like this strengthen and solidify the bond to the point where it is unbreakable going forward from here. Now, finally, this month, as we navigate late in the month, we are going to have a new moon. This new moon is happening in the sign just after yours, okay? So this is a new moon that speaks to matters of finances on the one hand, but it also speaks to self-esteem and self-worth. We have got a challenging connection between this new moon and Uranus, which brings surprises to the forefront and quick activities and quick moments. At the same time, though, it is this new moon that is going to be speaking in harmony with Chiron, and that allows a measure of healing energy to come in. So it looks like you are beginning an important time in the context of your finances and in the context of doing the work that self-love sometimes requires. For some of you, this new moon represents a very quick and surprising opportunity to earn more money. For some, there might be some mixed feelings as to what the job requires, if it's worth the money or isn't. And for others still, this might be a time when an unexpected expense does arise. Now, regardless of what shows up for you, remember, you are in a position of growth and in a position of strength. Your house is well, thanks to that supportive connection from Chiron, and where it is that you work from home or with homes, you've got that much more likelihood to move yourself towards greater prosperity at this time. What I love about this month for you, well, there's so much here, but I will say, I love that eclipse. I know it's not the easiest eclipse, and that energy of Saturn and Pluto together in your sign does make for some very strong emotions for you. But the thing is that it is an honest energy. It is an energy that invites you to consider whom it is that you are aligned with and if these partnerships are worthy of you. It invites you to consider where it is that you've been seeing things accurately and maybe where it is that you haven't. And in the process, you will find your own power and your own clarity in a way that is more valuable than anything in the world. Well, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for the 2020 special horoscope for your sign. Biggie started acting up a little bit. I don't know if you could hear him, but I'm sorry about that. I didn't want to stop. I kept stopping going because he was making so much noise. But what can I say? He's cute, so it's okay. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiaShaw.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive video scopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy. And now we get to see a little bit of Biggie, so enjoy that too. Take care. Hello, fabulous superstar Capricorn. Welcome to your horoscope for the year of 2020. This is your special horoscope. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing year it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And what an important time it is. So one of the really big things, of course, that's going to take place for you happens right out of the gate, very early in the year, and that is in January. It is in January that not only right around the 10th, you're going to have an eclipse in your opposite sign, but also we're going to have that conglomerate of planets in your sign, including the meeting of Saturn and Pluto. Now, as we're starting this year, we're already in eclipse season. We ended 2019 with an eclipse in your sign. That was a supremely harmonious one at that. So it is going to be as we start this year that on the one hand, there may very well be very